think when you're trying to activate a big brand idea, it is the human and the technological factor that come together. So there's some amazing and heroic fixing stories of how our frontline staff have helped fix our customers' problems in their time of need. So it's bringing the two together. In the case of smart crossings, where we've used technology to create an adaptive road, hacking roads, and this is, so this is leading edge emerging technology. But of course, what goes alongside that is the basic human insights about what's the problem we're trying to solve, how do people cross roads today, human behavior, psychology, neuroscience, etc. So I think it's in general holding the two things side by side, and it's the synergy between the two which is critical. I think this is a challenge because there is a threat. There's the stats which say 1 in 3 jobs are going to be obsoleted, and anything which talks to repeatable precision in theory could be defunct due to robots and AI machine learning. And we've got some evidence of that in that we have done some sort of sandpit exercises in our pricing function, and we found that machine learning models are incredibly effective. And that makes people a bit nervous, so it's evident that this isn't a one-way bet for human beings. So I think it's going to be a challenge to get people to accept that their roles are going to evolve and some roles are going to disappear. We're not in that space yet, but I think that's a challenge for technology, is how do you get people comfortable that their roles are going to change? And we haven't figured that out yet, and I don't think anybody has. But I know of an example that all the iPhones for China are made in a factory in Taiwan. That's a lot of iPhones. And they've started a 3-stage automation process, which ends up with tens of thousands of robots and not a single human being. So it's real and it's coming, but I don't think it's sort of profoundly hit yet to have to figure out how people respond to that. I'm an avid fan of the Humans program, and there you see in the extreme sort of what goes wrong. Thankfully we're not quite there yet. Well, for purely digital businesses, I think it's possible to optimize the whole engine, the whole ecosystem. And there may be a couple of examples of that. For legacy businesses that have with legacy assets or that integrate phone and digital channels, there's a sort of a messiness. In insurance, the purchase journey is incredibly complicated and can take weeks. That's much harder to get everything to talk to one another. A couple of vendors are now talking about how they can do that, but the problem is unless the data flows around, it's actually a challenge. So in insurance, we're all on a journey to be more digital, but there are some inherent inflexibilities in our systems and structures. So I think there's still quite a long journey. So in terms of pain points within customer experience more generally, we listen to complaints, we do root cause analysis, and essentially we have a never-ending snag list. And we've seen brand NPS on Direct Line increase by 15 points, not off a base, 15%, full percentage points in the last 4 years. And that's been through listening to our customers and addressing their needs. So for example, some of our customers say they're annoyed that they pay admin fees when they change address or profession. So uniquely for the industry, we took that away, and then we saw the impact on NPS. So there's a few layers to really understanding what's going on with customers. So we do traditional segmentation and insight when we're trying to, looking at positioning of a brand or launching a new proposition. So really sort of 101 of insight and research. We also very cognizant of broader consumer trends, so what's going on in the world. Insurance is really at the confluence of all the big tech trends right now. Blockchain, AI, connected home, driverless cars. Who'd have thought? Insurance is actually quite interesting because it's right at the heart of all those things. And so how do we interpret those technological trends through into customer adoption and genuine customer trends? So I think across those different layers, we're pretty in tune with customers, but of course never be arrogant that you've really sussed it, because customers are changing all the time. So this one's a double-edged sword. So the world of digital, the advent of digital, means that everything is more measurable. But that's a bit like methamphetamine in terms of its addictive qualities, and so the peril is you get sucked into that. And I see more and more examples of people losing sight of the fact that the medium is not the message, the message is the message. And so I think the biggest challenge of all of this is to sort of forget what's what and stay media agnostic. But as we've seen with issues of transparency, viewability, trust and so on. So I think digital is sort of both the savior of marketing, more quant and dynamic and data oriented, but also a danger in terms of being off with the digital fairies and forgetting that TV in many cases is still the most effective medium, and marketing 101 is still the good stuff.